It's time for the Geekend Update, bringing you science news from the restaurant at the end of the universe. Welcome to the Geekend Update. I'm your host, Ashley Esqueda. Our first story this week comes from our pals at SpaceX, the private rocket and spacecraft company looking to make space travel a commercial enterprise in the future. This week, they hit a new altitude milestone with Grasshopper, a vertical takeoff and landing vehicle. The 10-story tall Grasshopper has now completed 4 altitude tests, with the most recent seeing the rocket hover 24 stories above the ground before precisely touching back down in the center of its launch pad. That might not seem like a huge deal at first, but this particular project could mean a lot for the future of space exploration. Currently, when a rocket gets shot into space, portions of it drop off during launch and are lost forever. Then as the rocket goes higher, subsequent stages break off and burn up as they re-enter our atmosphere. If Grasshopper becomes as successful as SpaceX is hoping, that means reusable rockets, which would be a huge deal for future expeditions as it would be tremendously cost-effective by reducing the amount of money needed for space exploration over time. It's still in very early stages, but Grasshopper's progress looks promising, and we'll be keeping an eye on it as it develops. Our next story takes us into the fast-paced world of biomedical advances. The FDA here in the US officially approved the use of the OsteoFab patient-specific cranial device, marking the first time the FDA has given the green light to a non-metal 3D printed implant. Right now, 3D printed medical implants are made with titanium, making x-rays difficult and MRIs impossible. This new approved material, though, is polymer-based, offering the medical community the ability to create biocompatible implants for patients in need. One of the toughest places for a metal implant is the skull. Many patients with bone loss in the skull from disease or injury are unable to receive metal plates to cover the loss since they might need further monitoring, and a titanium plate wouldn't allow that without invasive surgery. The OsteoFab cranial device is not only biologically compatible, it's actually osteoconductive, so new bone can grow into it over time, and it's radiolucent, meaning it can be x-rayed without blocking or causing interference. It's already been successfully used to replace a whopping 75% of one person's skull, and president of Oxford Performance Materials, Scott DeFelice, states OPM's strategy is to continue to create biocompatible orthopedic implants for other parts of the body and hopefully bring lower overall costs to health providers and patients. Curiosity. Our favorite roving science lab on Mars has been collecting and testing samples on the red planet's terrain since last month, and now NASA is saying it appears Mars once supported a benign, habitable environment, for microbes at least. Curiosity drilled into fine-grained mudstone near an ancient stream bed in Gale Crater, and scientists identified hydrogen, oxygen, carbon, and other life-supporting elements in the rock, suggesting that at some point Mars was awash in water and could have been a place where microbes thrived. Minerals and clays were also found in the rock, pointing to potential food sources for the microbes and also indicating a neutral pH, which is important for microbes that can't live in harsh environments that are too acidic or salty. NASA, though, hasn't quite found the definitive building blocks for life on Mars, and Curiosity itself isn't actually equipped with testing equipment designed to find actual organic life, but the rover can identify organic molecules it finds during testing. Unfortunately, we'll have to wait for more in-depth drilling and testing as the sun will come between Earth and Mars for the month of April, making communication with Curiosity impossible. Pfft, the sun? Who does it think it is? The sun? That's it for the Geekend Update here at The Escapist. Send over your favorite science stories to the email address below, and feel free to suggest fun ideas for our intro as well. We'll be back next week, but until then, see you around the space-time continuum.